Good morning, students. In last video, we had discussed about a computer network and advantage of computer network, different network components, type of network. Teacher, in this video, we are going to discuss about the internet, intranet, and some important internet terminology. Let us start with the internet. The internet is the largest WAN of the world. It is a worldwide network of computer networks related to the business, academy, government and other networks. Therefore, internet is known as the network of networks. Internet is used for various important functions, which include several means of communication like online chat, file transfer, electronic mail, sharing of data, website on www. Data transmission over internet is controlled by a set of protocols popularly known as TCP/IP. Transmission control protocol takes care of transmission of the data between the computers, and internet protocol helps in identifying a network and the computers on the network. Both TCP and IP together ensure smooth data transfer among all the computers on the internet. Next one, the intranet. When a private network within an organization uses internet technology such as TCP/IP, email, chat, remote login, file upload and download, publishing content, etc., then such closed network is called intranet. User get an experience of working on internet while they are in intranet environment. Only employee of that particular organization can enter in that type of network. Next, some important internet terminology. The first one is World Wide Web. It is also known as www. World Wide Web is the largest collection of the information on the internet. It contains billions of websites that provide information in the form of text, animation, picture and videos. Thus, internet is like a library that contains billions of books. Next, a web. The web is a system of interlinked hypertext documents accessed via the internet. It is just the short form of World Wide Web or www. Next, web server. Web server can refer to either the hardware, that's a computer, or the software, that's a computer application, that helps to deliver content that can be accessed through the internet. Next, on the website. Website is a collection of related web pages that provide information about many things such as a person, business organization, educational and games institute. A website is like a book that contains many pages. And the web portal. Web portal is a specially designed website that hosts information from diverse sources together over a single user interface. Within the web browser, for example, link to all the schemes of government may be found on a single location or portal www.nic.in. Large organizations combine access to all their websites into one portal. Next one, the home page. When we enter the website address, the website will be opened. The first page of any website is known as home page. It consists of text, audio, video, pictures, animation and links. Next one, web pages. It is the part of a website. It is stored in an electronic form on computer connected to the internet. Next one, web browser. It is an application software used to retrieve and display web pages. It can be display information in different formats such as audio, video, text, images, or with combination of all. It helps to work with the internet. Some popular web browsers are Internet Explorer, Mozilla Firefox, Google Chrome, Safari, etc. Next was the Uniform Resource Locator. It is also known as URL. A URL indicates a resource on internet. It is commonly known as the web address also. It helps in establishing hyperlinks among web pages. URL has three main parts: website name, folder path, and resource name. For example, here the http://brightlineschool.org/pdf/syllabus-of-half-yearly-exam-class1.pdf. In this URL, first website name is brightlineschool.org, folder path is pdf/syllabus-of-half-yearly-exam-class. It means the syllabus of half yearly exam of class 1 is stored in PDF folder, and the resource name is the syllabus of half yearly exam class 1. Next one, the internet service provider. The organization or company that provides internet access to its customer is called internet service provider. The server at ISPs, in short, we can internet service provider is known as ISP. The server at ISP's premises connect directly to the internet. Computers of all the users connect with ISP's server through cable modem or wireless modems. For example, BSNL, Airtel, Jio, these are the internet service providers. Next one, domain name server. Domain name server are like a phone book on internet. They maintain a directory of website name or domain name and translate them into their corresponding IP addresses. Domain names are for human which are easily readable, but computer understand unique IP address only. A DNS gathers all IP addresses and domain name in the its access into a central registry, which is updated every time a new domain name and IP address is added or changed on the network. A web address, for example, www.google.com, is translated in its corresponding IP address by your internet service provider server and direct the request of web page made by your browser to the correct website. Now next, let's discuss about wireless network technology. Wireless or unguided media does not use any physical medium like cable or wire. Depending upon the distance and speed, different technologies are used like Bluetooth and Wi-Fi for transmission of data between the devices. So let's start with Bluetooth. Bluetooth is a very short-range wireless technology to connect devices. It uses low power frequency and can transmit data over short distance, typically up to 30 feet. Bluetooth devices generally communicate at less than 1 Mbps. Bluetooth technology is used primarily to support simple wireless networking of personal computing devices and peripherals, including mobile phones, PDA, wireless headsets, and printers. Next one, Wi-Fi. It is also known as wireless fidelity. Wi-Fi is a short range but high speed data transfer technology. It also provides wireless broadband internet access to the Wi-Fi enabled devices such as smartphones and laptops. Wi-Fi is also used to set up a wireless LAN. The typical range of a Wi-Fi network is 150 to 500 feet. Wi-Fi connections at airport, hotels, bars, coffee shop, etc. are called hotspots. Now next, let's discuss about network topologies. The physical layout of a network is called network topology. It refers to the type of cables, computers, and other devices. It determines the arrangement of computers' connections in a network. There are different types of topologies, like bus topology, ring topology, tree topology, star topology, mesh topology. First discuss about bus topology. In the bus network topology, every computer is connected to a main cable called bus. This cable acts as a common communication medium between the computers. This is image of bus topology. Here's the advantage. It enables an easy connection between the computers. It requires less cable length. It also has disadvantages. The entire network shut down if there is a break in a main cable. It is difficult to identify a problem if the entire network shut down. Next one, mesh topology. In the mesh topology, messages sent on network can take any path from the source to the destination between every computer in this type of topology. It's connected with the others. This is image of mesh topology. Its advantage, if any cable or nodes fail, there are many other ways for other nodes to communicate. And disadvantages, it is expensive because a lot of cable is required. So that's all for today. Thank you.